So you have to film you.
Okay, last lesson we had ended with how to create a new branch and how to manage it with the master. Today I would like to start with another command that is git stash, that is always related with the branch. The situation is that you are working on a branch, and at a certain point you would like to move immediately to another branch, but your work has not been finished yet. So you need somehow, you don't want to come to this work, so you want just to store it like in a shelf, and then go back to this work and complete it. So now I'm in my Hello World project, and in the branch, in the master branch. Now I move to the first branch, so I need to check out first and score branch. I check the status of the branch, and there is nothing to comment. I open my clips and I see I look at the code. For example, I add some lines. And I see that there is a new, the Hello World file has been modified, so it is ready to be added, the staging area, and then okay. But for some reason, I needed to move back to the master branch, so I try to move to the directly to the master, so git checkout master, and git signals me an error. Because I have some modified file that I didn't commit, so I cannot move back to the master. So the idea is that I don't want to commit this modification, so I just run the git stash command. The work that I have done is somehow saved by git, and now I can move back to the master. Git branch. And now I'm in the master branch. Now, if I would like to go back to the first branch and continue to work with the code, I can resume the stash and start to work again. To do this, I move to the first branch, so git checkout. I can look at to retract the last stash and look for all the stashes that I have done. So git. Stash list. And here I see that I have just one stash. So to start again from this point, work, I run the command git stash pop, and then I write the stash modifier stash 0. So in my code I see that I have again the last line that I have happened. And the git tells me that there is a new file that is ready to be added. So now I can start to work again from the last point of this branch. Now that I have added the file and committed it, I can move easily to the master branch, simply with the git checkout master. And again I'm in the master. So git stash is a command that allows you to move from one branch to another without committing your version history. At some point of your work, maybe you are interested to save that version, and so you want to create a tag. A tag is just a short name that you can use to identify a specific time level of the development of your code. To create a tag, you simply use the command git. Tag minus a you add the name of this tag. Usually you put a lowercase d, dot and a number, for example 0.1, and then you can add a descriptive message with the minus m, and then return like first. Now I have created a tag on my local machine, local repository. So I would like to push this on GitHub. So I just run the command git push origin, and the tag name, so d0.1. Now I check on GitHub for my tag, and here in this menu, the release, I can see that there is the first version of my code, and this is the descriptive message for this release. This is very useful when you develop a code, sometimes when you arrive at a good point to create a tag, so that tag is very easy to retrieve that code. So you don't have to go back with just using commits, but you can use the tag to go back to that version. initial with the clone, you don't just copy the files that you have in the repository, but also you take a copy of the version history of this repository, the .git folder. If you just simply download the project as a zip file, you just take the files but without the version history of the repository. This is the difference between git clone and download the zip of the project. Another way to start from an existing repository is to create a folder. Fork is somehow similar to git clone, since you create not only the files but also the history of the repository. But why git clone create a copy on your machine? Git fork create a copy of the repository on your GitHub account. So when after creating a fork of a project on my GitHub account, I have to run the git clone command to have a copy of that repository on my local machine, local repository. To create a fork, as before, you go to the repository you are interested in, and here you can see the fork. And here you can, of course, you cannot fork a project on your GitHub account. You have to go to GitHub account of someone else and fork the project. So if you want to try, you can go search for Nicola Tomini and my hello world project and try to fork it.
How to find your account?
Copy
your name?
The my ID / my hello world. I think you should find it.
I have forked.
You have forked. So you have a copy of my project or your GitHub account. If you want to have this project on your machine, just run the command git clone and the HTTPS
of
your account. With the fork, you have essentially two options. One is just to have a copy of the entire repository, and you want to go on to develop this repository by yourself. Otherwise, the second option is to develop it by yourself, but try to continue to collaborate with the owner of this repository. So you can ask to the owner of this repository to add your modification to the original repository. So in this figure we have this one is the original repository. Alice forked this repository on her GitHub account, and So the main difference between the fork, clone, and download are that download simply download the project, just the files with no version history. So your this download will become out of update when the owner of the GitHub account will update his repository with new modification. If you perform a git clone, you download on your machine both the files but also the version history. And with the fork, you create a copy of a repository on your GitHub ID. And from that, you can git clone on your and then here in this web link, you can find a short tutorial on how to create open a pull request in order to ask to someone else to merge your modification to his own repository. Have you any questions? Have you any questions?
No.